Yo,
what's up? I'm Adam.
I'm Patrick.
And I'm Danny.
And what we want to do in this video is really talk about Azure SQL Managed Instances and this thing called Managed Instance Link. And I brought Danny along to help us out with this topic. Danny, thank you so much for joining Guy in a Cube in this video. Tell us a little bit about yourself so folks know who you are and what you do.
So my name is Danny. I am a program manager with SQL Managed Instance team. I specialize in high availability and data mobility in this team. And I've been with Managed Instance since the day one when the service launched. For all of you guys that don't know it, Managed Instance is the most compatible, fully managed SQL Server in the cloud.
Wow. Patrick, have you used Managed Instance at all?
No, I have not.
You should.
I have to try.
So with Managed Instance Link, tell us a little bit about that. Like, what are the reasons why I would even care about this?
With Managed Instance being a modern SQL Server in the cloud, we wanted to make a bridge between on-prem SQL servers and Managed Instance as a SQL server in the cloud. So we built MI-Link as a hybrid connectivity to connect the on-prem environment, which could be hosted anywhere, either in your data center or other clouds, or under your desk to Azure SQL Managed Instance. So probably you guys know that on-prem, you can have availability groups and you can have read replica and availability groups. So think of it as a Managed Instance being a read replica to your SQL Server on-premises. We're essentially leveraging the same technology stack and all the data is replicated near real time. It's like magic.
Wait. So you're telling me if I want to set up high availability, I have my on-premises SQL Server wherever it's running, under Adam's desk, right? And I want to have some type of high availability with that database. I don't need to install and set up SQL Server. I can just go spin up a managed instance, get it connected, and use that.
That is correct. And SQL Server 2016 and up are supported. And the upgrade is with SQL Server 2022. Where you can have a full DR. So with 2016 to 2019, it's one-way replication, but with 22, you can have two-way replication. You can have full DR in the cloud by just spinning up the SQL Server Managed Instance in the cloud.
So everyone should pause this video, go upgrade all your servers to SQL 2022, and then come back.
No, you can use 2016. That's okay. Fine. Okay. That's fine. For what we're going to show you, yeah. Actually, there are three scenarios maybe that we can double click on.
All right.
Well, MI-Link is your hybrid connectivity between on-prem and Azure SQL Managed Instance in the cloud. It could be used in different ways. The first way would be to keep the link for as long as you need it. You can run it for weeks, months, years at a time. Has no limits, really. And then you can offload your read-only workloads to the cloud, either application workloads, or you can run analytics in the cloud. Second scenario is, because it's based on always-on technology, you can have minimum downtime migration to Azure if and when you want to migrate to Azure and maybe have critical workload on premises and you care about minimum downtime. That's probably the best solution that we have for this. And number three, with SQL Server 2022 only, you can have full DR in the cloud by being able to fail over to the cloud, to Azure SQL Managed Instance, and back, either online or offline.
All right. So Danny, enough of all this talking. Everyone knows here how we like to do it on Guy in a Cube. We want to see that demo. So let's head over to your desktop.
So here on my desktop, I have a pre-installed SQL Server 2019 and SQL MI demo database on one end. And on the other end, I have Managed Instance in Azure. And then that database using the MI link is replicated near real time. So all the data that I insert on SQL Server MI demo database will instantaneously near real time be replicated to my read replica in the cloud to Managed Instance. To illustrate that, this database has some data and I have Power BI attached. To manage
Ooh, we
instance.
Love Power BI.
This is especially for you today, guys.
Nice.
So here's where I show that the source of data is this managed instance in the cloud. So this Power BI report is running off the managed instance. But have a look at this. I'm going to go back to SMS to the SQL Server, and I'm going to insert some more data on the SQL Server side.
So you inserted it on the on-premises server, correct?
Yes.
Okay, got it.
Here on SQL Server. And we can show that here by select server name, data inserted on SQL Server 2019. I did nothing. And here on the Power BI report, which is running off the managed instance, meaning our read-only replica, I have added more data. So this graph will change. It's like near real time to the cloud.
Ooh, Patrick likes that term, near real time.
Yeah. When I think about availability groups that we did when they first came out. I connect to the listener. Is there a listener here or is it not transparent? I have to explicitly, for my read only, connect to the managed instance endpoint itself.
In this scenario today that we have available, we explicitly need to point to the connection string of the managed instance. But listener endpoint, I like technology, is something that we're working on. So stay tuned.
All right. I have to bring Dani back when we get that. Yeah. So you said near real time also, like what's the latency between the time that I insert it on-prem to when it shows up in managed instance?
So it really depends on a number of factors. First of all, it depends on the network bandwidth that you have and how much that network bandwidth is utilized. It depends if you're running any other traffic through that link and on the latency of the link. And of course, if you are in US and maybe your managed instance is in Australia, it is going to have additional latency.
Australia always has
to
latency,
monitor. So that's okay. But to monitor all of that, you just query a DMV on your SQL Server and you see the replication lag and you know what you're dealing with. And it's the same DMV as you would use it for your AG replication. It's essentially the same thing. One more important thing, people might ask a question, hey, do I need to have availability group? Do I need to have multiple nodes, Windows Server failover cluster, all of that? You may if you have, but this works on a single server node only. And there's an extra mile that we did on this one. Typically, Always On was only available in Enterprise and Developer Editions. With the release that we made, and of course, we had to get special approvals from all the lawyers and stuff, we've actually enabled this functionality in Standard Edition as well.
Wow. Dani knows some people, and he got this into Standard. So now, is it's available in Standard for SQL 2016 as well, or you have to be in 22?
2016 up, Standard, Developer, Enterprise supported.
Wow.
The one-way link for 2016 and up, and the offline DR for 2022 is in GA. The only part that it's still in preview is the online DR for 22, which we're working on.
Let us know in the comments if you want to see how to actually set this up. We can follow up with a video on that. Dani, thank you so much for being with us. If you enjoyed this type of thing with SQL, go check out this other playlist up above where you can learn more about T-SQL that Patrick is walking you through. As always, thank you so much for watching from all of us here in GynaCube. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.